What's up, everyone, and welcome back to Movie Race. Netflix is the world's leading internet entertainment service with 158 million paid memberships in over 190 countries, enjoying different TV series, documentaries, and feature films across a wide variety of genres and languages. Members can watch as much as they want, anytime, anywhere, on any internet-connected screen. Members can play, pause, and resume watching all without commercials or commitments. With hundreds of different TV series readily available for streaming, it's easy for us to miss or overlook some of the shows, especially when they are being overshadowed by some of the major players in the industry, shows like Stranger Things, Orange is the New Black, or 13 Reasons Why, being as captivating as they are. So today, we're turning the spotlight to some of the lesser-watched Netflix original shows. With that said, let's jump right into the list. The first show we have on our list is Anne with an E. Anne with an E was the 2017 adaptation of the 1908 novel Anne of Green Gables by Lucy Maud Montgomery, published under L.M. Montgomery. Anne with an E was not the first of its kind, as there are four films that date back to 1985 as well that share the same names as the original books. The series is best described as a coming-of-age story about a plucky and imaginative young orphan girl named Anne Shirley. She sees life in a very unique and at times overly dramatic way, and won't hesitate to speak her mind, which often gets her in quite a bit of trouble. The story first begins in the late 19th century, when brother and sister Matthew and Marilla Cuthbert, both past their prime, decide to take on an orphan boy to help out around their ancestral farm of Green Gables, on the outskirts of the town Avonlea on Prince Edward Island. When Matthew goes to pick up the child at the railway station, he finds not a boy, but a high-spirited and talkative girl. Initially, the Cuthberts, Marilla in particular, are inclined to return her to the orphanage. Anne insists that she can help out as good as any boy, and over time, with her unique charms, she is able to win the two over. Throughout the series, Anne displays boundless enthusiasm, which is nevertheless easily turned into despair when things go wrong, which they often do, especially when she's enrolled in school, where she meets her best friend Diana Barry, Gilbert Blythe, who takes the role of her romantic interest, as well as many other unforgettable characters. The series also contains very progressive themes, featuring many LGBTQ characters and their stories. It promotes and teaches egalitarianism as well, never hesitating to remind both Anne as well as us viewers back home that anyone can be who they want and love who they love, regardless of gender, sexuality, and ethnicity. The show has two seasons available, with a third set to be released January 3rd of 2020. Next up on our list is a show called You. You is an American psychological thriller television series based on the novel of the same name by Caroline Kepnes. The first series follows the story of Joe Goldberg, a bookstore manager in New York who, upon meeting Guinevere Beck, an aspiring writer, becomes immediately infatuated with her. His infatuation quickly escalates into a toxic obsession. He employs the use of social media and other technology not only to track her presence, but to remove obstacles to their own romance as well. Somehow, despite his stalker-like tendencies, Joe still manages to come off as a likable character due to the older brother and mentor-like relationship he has with his kid-next-door neighbor, Paco, who has an abusive home life and is always trying to escape by reading tons of books. Joe sees himself in the young boy and is always trying to protect him and teach him how to protect both himself as well as the boy's mother from his ex-cop stepfather. The series thrives on showing people how toxic relationships can be, that even people with the best of intentions can become consumed by their own selfishness. Coming in at number 3 on our list is The Dark Crystal, Age of Resistance. This is a prequel to the 1982 Jim Henson film The Dark Crystal. The story takes place on the fantastical world of Thra, home to a race of fairy-like creatures called the Gel, who are ruled over by the seemingly immortal Skeksis, an alien race with twisted and ragged bird-like features who the Gelfling call the Lords of the Crystal. The Crystal of Truth acts as an energy source that keeps the world in balance. The story centers around three younger Gelfling: Rian, a guard stationed at the Castle of the Crystal, Bria, a scholarly princess, and Deet, the caring animal lover, as they discover the dark and disturbing truth behind the Skeksis' so-called immortality and how it relates to the Darkening, a horrible plague that corrupts and infects every living thing across Thra. The Skeksis use the crystal against its intended purpose by slowly draining the planet of its energy to keep themselves young forever. Through the overuse and abuse of the crystal, it could no longer keep the Skeksis alive, and so they were forced to find a new source of eternal youth, namely the Gelfling. They began killing off the native people of Thra in order to drain them of their very life essence, which works as a sort of youth potion. As the Gelfling worshipped overlords, the Skeksis, are exploitative, taxing essence suckers who are destroying the world, Rian, Bria, and Deet inspire a rebellion against their people. A lot of people don't give the show the chance it deserves because of the strange and otherworldly appearance of the characters, and as a result, most of the fan base is compromised of older generations who grew up watching its 1982 predecessor. Don't let the alien appearances stop you from enjoying the magical experience the writers of this show created. With the first season comprising of 10 episodes, each one is approximately an hour in length, so you won't run out of watching material in a hurry. Taking up the fourth spot on our list is The Innocents. This is a show about teens in love, complicated family relationships, and knowing and accepting yourself. Our hero of the series, June McDaniel, has the power to shift between bodies. Unlike most superheroes, though, she can barely control her gift and tries to keep it hidden. She and her love interest, Harry Polk, both defy their families that would keep them apart, opting to run away together. Things take a big change when June unwittingly transforms into a man. Harry is understandably alarmed, and from there, none of their escape plans go the way they imagined. June's ability is terrifying and powerful, and it's also a direct parallel to some of the potent emotional realities of being a young woman. In this case, her talent as a shapeshifter taps into the deep well of adolescent anxiety about finding yourself, deciding who to be. The following for this show is not large, despite the intriguing concept, largely because of its romance-centered storyline that was written with teens and preteens in mind. It is still an enjoyable show that deserves more attention than it received upon the year of its release. It was reportedly canceled after only a single season, leaving many fans disappointed. Have you watched the show before? Do you think it deserved to be canceled, or should it have gone on for longer? Tell us what you think in the comments down below. Closing up our list at number 5, we have The Dragon Prince. The Dragon Prince is a computer-animated television series set in the medieval fantasy world, which is rich with magic derived from 6 primal elements: the sun, moon, stars, earth, sky, and ocean. The elves were born with an inner ability to tap into primal elements and were thus able to use the magic. The humans, however, could not utilize primal magic until one day they discovered and began to practice the art of dark magic, which is fueled by the As a consequence, they were driven off by the dragons and elves of Zadia to the other end of the continent, where they founded the 5 human kingdoms. The Breach, the fiery border between the 2 halves of the continent, were guarded by Thunder, the king of dragons. Fast forward 1,200 years, the humans have killed the Dragon King and supposedly destroyed his heir's egg. They are now on the cusp of an unnecessary war. The elves attempt to assassinate the human King Harrow and his heir, the young Prince of Ezran, in retaliation for the egg's destruction. One among the 11 assassins, the young Rayla, among with Ezran and his older half-brother Calum, discovers that the Dragon King's egg wasn't in fact destroyed, but stolen by Viren, King Harrow's advisor, and kept in a hidden chamber located within the castle. Together they try to return the egg to the dragons to prevent war between the humans and elves, but Viren, believing the elves will use the Dragon Prince that resides inside the egg as an unstoppable weapon, seizes power after the king dies in the assassination attempt and sends his children after the fugitives to kill the princes and recover the egg at all costs. Many people will not give the Dragon Prince much consideration when selecting what they want to watch, but we can assure you that while the target audience is young, the story is greatly enjoyed by teens and adults that watch it as well. The plot is well thought out, paced very well, and has subtle adult humor sprinkled throughout, making it the perfect show to watch with the entire family. It currently has 2 seasons, with its 3rd season set to release later this month, on November 22nd. With that out of the way, it's time for us to wrap up this video. What do you think about the shows on our list? What are some of the underrated shows you think others should watch? Let us know in the comments down below. And don't forget to subscribe to Movie Rays and hit the little notification bell below to be notified every time we upload a new video.